Dear students, in the first video, we classified the types of motions like this. Here, periodic motion was classified as circular motion and oscillatory motion. If you consider circular motion, for example, moon around earth, say it is approximately in circular orbit, here, see, when the moon is moving around earth, so always this is attracted by, so due to gravitational force it will be moving around this, and the gravitational force of attraction between earth and moon is given by F is equal to G m1 m2 by r square. It means here the force between these two is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. So here the force is inverse square. See, this depends upon like this. So as far as circular motion is concerned, force is inversely proportional to square of the distance here. If we consider the oscillatory motion, let us consider some examples. For example, spring, whether it is oscillating vertically or horizontally, the restoring force is given by the spring force, and that is minus kx. Similarly, if we consider simple pendulum, here also actually here we get a formula like this. F is equal to minus mg x by l. See, here M, G and L are constants, therefore you can write minus kx. So these two, in case of these two examples, they are obeying the mass law F is equal to minus kx, which obey this law are called to execute, see, simple harmonic motion is a special case of oscillatory motion. Actually, this oscillatory motion can be classified into here unharmonic, here linearly harmonic. This linearly harmonic is called simple harmonic motion. See, in this way, now we are going to consider the simple harmonic motion, which is a special case of oscillatory motion. You should read the points to ponder. We have very valuable points in this. See here, every periodic motion is not simple harmonic motion. See, just now we have seen here, this is periodic motion. Periodic motion is classified as circular motion and oscillatory motion. So what is given here? Every periodic motion is not simple harmonic motion. See, if we take periodic motion like this, it is a set. Inside this, circular motion is a subset and oscillatory motion is another subset. So this is periodic motion. So circular motion is a periodic motion, oscillatory motion is a periodic motion, like that. See here what is given, every periodic motion is not simple harmonic motion. Only that periodic motion governed by the force law F is equal to minus kx is simple harmonic. So when it comes to circular motion, here the force law, the governing force law is G m1 m2 by r square, and here the force law governing is minus kx. See, there is a lot of difference here. See, that is why it is given, only that periodic motion governed by the force law F is equal to minus kx is simple harmonic. Now another important item is given here. Sixth one, a combination of two simple harmonic motions with arbitrary amplitudes and phases is not necessarily periodic. So here we have gone through Fourier statement here. Fourier statement is any periodic function can be expressed as a superposition of sine and cosine functions of different time periods with suitable coefficients. So here, so any linear combination of sine and cosine functions cannot be periodic. That is suggested here. There are some limitations. It is periodic only if frequency of one motion is an integral multiple of the other's frequency. For example, here one is given here. See, here if in the first example both are having of course same frequency, but in this example, see, this is omega t, this is 2 omega t, this is the integral multiple of this, this is 2, this is here the frequency is 2 times this frequency. See, its frequency is let me write here 2 pi by omega. Its frequency is 2 pi by 2 omega and its frequency is 2 pi by 4 omega. See here, if this is treated as T naught, this becomes T naught by 2, this becomes T naught by 4. See, this frequency is twice this here. It is given, see here, if this is taken as T naught, see this becomes T1 becomes T naught by 2 and T2 becomes T naught by 4. See, it's we have taken the second example. Here this is given. For the first term the time period was 2 pi by omega, for the second term 2 pi by 2 omega, for the third term 2 pi by 4 omega. If we consider 2 pi by omega as T naught, this becomes T naught by 2 and this becomes T naught by 4. So all this is about time periods. But frequency is defined as frequency is equal to 1 by capital T. So now let us find the frequencies here. Frequency, see, reciprocal of time period is frequency. So here this is T naught, so its reciprocal is say nu naught. Now for the second term, see here this is T naught by 2, its reciprocal will be 2 by T naught. So here 1 by T naught is if taken as nu naught, so it becomes 2 into 1 by T naught means 2 nu naught. Similarly here for this, the period is T naught by 4 and its reciprocal value gives us the frequency, and this is 4 times 1 by T naught or 4 times nu naught, therefore here you write 4 nu naught. See here the frequencies of other terms are integer times this frequency. Therefore, see what is given in this period. Once again, let us see in the points to ponder, very important. Sixth one, a combination of two simple harmonic motions with arbitrary amplitudes and phases is not necessarily periodic. It is periodic only if frequency of one motion is an integral multiple of the other's frequency. See here, frequency of this is an integral multiple of this frequency. Frequency of third term is an integral multiple of the first term. So when it is like this, when it is integral multiple of the other frequency, then only the linear combination of sine and cosine functions can be periodic. The periodic motion is classified into circular motion and oscillatory motion. And again, this oscillatory motion is classified into unharmonic oscillations and linear harmonic oscillators. Now, we are going to consider in detail the linear harmonic oscillations. or simple harmonic oscillation. So simple harmonic motion is a special case of oscillatory motion, and under that we have two important examples. One is simple pendulum and the other is spring mass system. So both are governed by the force law F is equal to minus kx. So which are governed by this force law are taken as executing simple harmonic motion. So simple harmonic motion is a special case of oscillatory motion, and we are considering the simple harmonic motion in detail. See, there is a long answer question. Define simple harmonic motion. Show that the motion of projection of a particle performing uniform circular motion on any diameter is simple harmonic motion. It's simple harmonic. See here, first in this question, the first part is defining simple harmonic motion. So let us have the definition of simple harmonic motion. See how it is defined. See the definition one for simple harmonic motion. How it is defined, let us read. To and fro oscillatory motion of a particle about origin and between limits minus a and plus a is called simple harmonic if the displacement of the particle from origin varies with time, as x is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. See here, the particle is oscillating on x-axis and it is to and fro motion. So the particle is moving to and fro. It is moving along the x-axis and it is moving about origin. To right side of the origin, it is going maximum up to plus a, and to left side of the origin, it is going to a maximum up to minus a. So here the maximum displacement is plus a. On both sides of the origin, the maximum displacement is a. So the particle is moving to and fro. It is moving to and fro between minus a and plus a limits. And at any time, at a time, arbitrarily at some time, suppose you could find the particle here. Now if we take the distance of the particle from the origin, that is called displacement at time t. So if this displacement is governed by the equation x of t is equal to a cos omega t plus pi, then you can say it's oscillatory motion as simple harmonic motion. And in this equation, capital A is called magnitude or maximum displacement, and omega is called angular frequency or angular speed. And the angle beside cos function, this angle is called phase angle or simply phase. And in this, see, pi is called initial phase. It is called initial phase. Initial phase means phase at t is equal to 0. See, actually all this is phase only, but when this represents phase at time t. But if you want initial phase, initial means at t is equal to 0. So at t is equal to 0 means if you substitute in place of t is 0, this becomes 0, so pi remains. So that's why this pi is called initial phase. So in this way, we have defined simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion is defined as to and fro oscillatory motion of a particle about along a line About origin, between limits minus a and plus a, is called simple harmonic if the displacement of the particle from origin varies with time, as x of t is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. So now let us go for the second definition. So in the definition 1, the particle is oscillating along x-axis. But here, the example can be taken as simple pendulum. Simple pendulum. See, the bob will be moving to and fro along x-axis. So, but we can consider another example, mass spring system. If you pull the mass down and leave it, it will execute simple harmonic motion vertically. For this, see the definition 2. Up and down, oscillatory motion of a particle about origin. See, about origin means here you can say about origin, or you can say mean position. Mean position. About origin and between limits minus a and plus a is called simple harmonic if the displacement of the particle from origin varies with time, as y of t is equal to a sin omega t plus pi. See, you compare these two. Here displacement is a function of, it is a function of cosine function. Here it is a function of sine function. X of t, x is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. Here y is equal to a sin omega t plus pi. X is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. Y is equal to a sin. Both are periodic functions. So if the displacement at any time, at a time t, is governed by this equation or this equation, in both cases it can be treated as its to and fro oscillatory motion can be taken as simple harmonic motion. Here a question is given in the long answer questions. Define simple harmonic motion. Show that the motion of projection of a particle performing uniform circular motion on any diameter is simple harmonic. Okay. So in the question, he has told any diameter, on any diameter. But here, here I have drawn a circle diagram. See, x-axis, this is one diameter, this is another diameter, this is a horizontal diameter and this is vertical diameter. So let us consider these two diameters. First, let us consider the horizontal diameter. Now this is a particle, and this particle is moving on a circle with angular speed omega. And we say this as UCM, uniform circular motion, means its angular speed is constant. At time, initially, say the particle is here. So at t is equal to 0, the position of the particle is here, and it is represented by a position vector. And after time t, the particle moved from here to here, and its position is represented by another position vector. Yes. See here, if its initial position is here, and a line joining origin and initial position of the particle, this is making some angle pi with x-axis. This angle is called as initial phase. Phase at t is equal to 0 is called initial phase. Okay. Now, to move from here to here, it took t seconds of time. So, what will be the angular displacement? See, according to angular speed, omega, angular speed. Omega means angular speed. How it is defined? It is defined as delta theta by delta t. Or by cross multiplication, we have delta theta is equal to omega delta t. So here, if the time taken to move from here to here is t seconds, so in place of this you write t, and this is omega. So the angular displacement from here to here, the angular displacement will be omega t. Therefore, you have written here omega t. Now, the total angle. Now, we have drawn here. We are taking the projection of the particle on vertical diameter. So here we are considering on vertical diameter. So you have taken the particle's projection on vertical diameter. So the projection touches the y-axis at n point. So now what we are going to prove, if the particle is moving with constant angular speed, if it is under uniform circular motion, if the particle is under uniform circular motion, its projection point will make simple harmonic motion on the vertical diameter. With this we can see. See here, the particle under uniform circular motion is say here. Then its projection on y-axis, that projection point n, is at origin. Now when it comes, suppose it is moving with angular speed omega. See, after some time this particle will be here. Then its projection point is here, and after some time the particle will be here. Then the projection will be there only, and after some time the particle comes here. Now the projection point is n. When the particle comes here, the projection point is here. When the particle comes here, the projection point is here. And when the particle comes to this point, here only the projection point. And when it comes here, it will be here. And again this particle comes here, so it has completed one round. So in this one round, so how the projection point is moving? See, the projection point is at origin, so it is rising up and reaching the maximum displacement. See, this is plus A, this is minus A. So it has started, it was at mean position, and it is, as the particle is moving in the first quarter, the projection point is moving from origin to this extreme, this extreme point. In the second quarter, as the particle is moving from here to here, see, the projection point moved to down and reached the origin. And in the third quarter, see, from here, so you see that the projection point is moving down and reached the lowest position, that is minus A. And in the fourth quarter, see, it is again rising up and reaching origin. That is, the projection point is, see, the particle initial position is this and final position. As this has completed one round, here the projection point n first gone up, afterwards came back to origin point, afterwards came, it went down, and again it came to the original position. In this way it has completed one oscillation. By the time the particle completed one revolution, the projection point first went upside, afterwards down, afterwards to the negative y direction, and again to the origin point. In this way it has completed one revolution. But one thing is, as the particle is moving on a circle, the projection point is moving up and down. it is making to and fro motion on y axis. But this can be taken as an oscillatory motion about the origin on y axis. But whether this oscillatory motion is a simple harmonic or not, that should be decided. How we decide that? Because already we are having definitions. What are the definitions? See, the displacement, the distance ON, here the distance ON is y of t, and this y of t must be equal to y of t, the displacement must be equal to ON is equal to y of t. This must be equal to a sine omega t plus pi. If this ON value is equal to a sine omega t plus pi, then only we can say the up and down oscillatory motion is simple harmonic. Okay, now let us see. Here, at it, initially the particle was here making an angle pi with x axis, and after t seconds it moved from here to here, making angular displacement omega t according to the definition. See, now at this position, so we have taken a projection of this particle onto y axis, and that projection point is n, and the distance from O to N is y of t. So now, see, this is omega t and this is pi. So the total angle is omega t plus pi. And now you see this line and this line. These two are parallel lines. And this is, if here this angle is omega t plus pi, this also will be omega t plus pi, because alternate angles are equal. So this also omega t plus pi. Now, if you want to y of t, see, this is opposite to this angle. So let us take sine omega t plus pi is equal to, see, opposite by adjacent. Opposite is y of t by up, and this hypotenuse is nothing but the radius of the circle, and that is a. So by cross multiplying you get y of t is equal to a sine omega t plus pi. This is nothing but, this is the defining equation of simple harmonic motion. So now we can say, as the particle is under uniform circular motion with omega angular speed, its projection point will be under simple harmonic motion. That is confirmed. So now here we considered the vertical diameter. Instead of vertical diameter, let us consider horizontal diameter. That is x-axis. Initially the particle is here, and the angle made by the x-axis is called initial phase. In t seconds, the particle moved from here to here. So omega means what? The angle made by the particle in 1 second time. In 1 second, it describes angle omega. The time taken to move from here to here is t seconds. So in t seconds, by how much angle it moved? So t by 1 into omega, that is omega t. So in t seconds, it described omega t angle. So that is shown here. So here to here pi, here to here omega t. So therefore the total angle becomes omega t plus pi. Omega t plus pi. See, this is a right angle triangle, and you have taken the particle's projection on x-axis. The projection point now this time is on x-axis. Now from origin to n gives displacement x of t. So now to find expression for x of t, see this is becoming adjacent side to this angle, therefore we use cos of omega t plus pi. Cos means adjacent side by hypotenuse. So to this angle the adjacent side is on and hypotenuse is op. Op is nothing but the radius of the circle plus a, here minus a, here plus a, here minus a. So the radius of the circle is a. Now if we cross multiplying we get on is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. On is nothing but x of t, a cos omega t plus pi. But this is nothing but the defining equation of simple harmonic motion. So you can say the projection point, as this particle is making uniform circular motion, its projection point is making simple harmonic motion. So it will be making to and fro oscillatory motion on the x-axis about origin. So this is proved. See, at the end of a lesson, points to ponder will be given. These give very valuable information for us. You should not miss going through these points. So under the points to ponder, here it is given here. The motion of a, see here, for motion of a particle to be simple harmonic, its displacement x must be expressible in either of the following forms. See, one is x is equal to a cos omega t plus alpha. Here alpha is given, but we wrote pi. So x is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. So just now we have shown here. So the projection point, see here, the as the particle is making uniform circular motion, its projection on x-axis is making simple harmonic motion, and its displacement from origin at any time is given by x t is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. So this is given here, x of t is equal to a cos omega t plus alpha. Now here, if the projection point is taken on vertical diameter, its displacement at any time is given by yt is equal to a sin omega t plus pi. That is given here. See, x is equal to b sin omega t plus beta. And see, afterwards, in addition to these two expressions, another expression is given. X is equal to a cos omega t plus b sin omega t, a linear combination of sine and cosine functions. So now we are having three definitions for SHM. This is one definition, this is second definition, and this is third definition. This is third. But we have to first prove that whether this represents, actually in definitions we are having only these two, but now we have to check whether these two represents a simple harmonic motion or not, whether this represents simple harmonic motion or not. Let us see. Now let us see. Let A is equal to d sine pi. Y sin pi, why it cannot be cos pi, means here already cosine function is there. That's why I am taking sine function. And B is equal to D cos pi. Now let me substitute in this. D can be taken common. See, this expression, if you look at this expression, see, you get a trigonometric relation here. See, suppose this is A, and suppose this is B, A, suppose this is B. Now you can write here sin A cos B. Sin A cos B plus cos A sin B. Sin A cos B plus cos A sin B is equal to sin A plus B. You know very well about this trigonometric relation. So using this relation, this can be written as sin A plus B. That is sin omega t plus pi. So here we got x is equal to d sin omega t plus l. So here this equation is expressible. This expression is expressed as like this. Now let us search in the definition 1, definition 2. See, this coincides with our definition 2. So we can say the given equation, the given expression is simple harmonic according to, so by definition 2 we can say the given equation is simple harmonic. So the given expression stands for SHM because it is coinciding with one of the two definitions. That's why here in the points to ponder, this also added here. See here, one is x is equal to A cos omega t plus y, another is B sin omega t plus y, and third is A cos omega t plus B sin omega t. So if the displacement is either this or this or this, in three cases, these three cases are allowed to confirm that it is simple harmonic. See, like this problem also will be given. They will ask whether it is simple harmonic. Then if it is expressible in this form, and here either we get first definition or second definition, in both cases we can say it is simple harmonic. And now what is this D? We have to define this D. See here, from these two we can get the D value. See here, sin pi is equal to, see, taking square, see, A square is equal to d square sin square pi, and squaring the second equation, b square is equal to d square cos square pi, adding a square plus b square. So adding, we get d square taken common sin square pi plus cos square pi, but sin square pi plus cos square pi value is 1. So d square is equal to a square plus b square, or d is equal to under root a square plus b square. So in this way we have defined d coming here. And if you want this pi value, so you just divide this equation by this equation. If this equation is divided by this equation, d and d gets cancelled. Sin pi by cos pi is tan pi. And here a by b. and pi is equal to tan inverse a by b. So in this way, these two terms also defined here. So with this, we completed this. Now, let us do this problem. Solved example 8.3. Which of the following represent a simple harmonic motion? And B, periodic but not simple harmonic. So first one is sin omega t minus cos omega t. Let us do the first one. F of t is equal to sin omega t minus cos omega t. So if you look at this expression, it is in the form a sin omega t plus b cos omega t. This is in the form. So for this, we have already, just now we proved that this is simple harmonic. Okay. So now, if this is in the form, say comparing, we get in place of A there is 1, and in place of B you are having minus 1. So D is equal to A square plus B square under root 1 square minus 1 square under root. So you are getting root 2. And pi is equal to tan inverse A by B. That is equal to tan inverse 1 minus 1. So that gives, now angle, see tan inverse minus 1. So actually tan 45 is equal to 1, or in radians tan pi by 4 is equal to 1. But here you are getting minus 1, it means minus pi by 4. Angle is minus pi by 4. So now the given for this, see this can be written as d sine omega t plus pi. That is d means root 2 sine omega t plus, see here pi value minus pi by 4, so minus pi by 4. So in this way, the given expression is expressible as d sin omega t plus pi. And this is nothing but a defining equation of SHM. Therefore, you can say the given expression is simple harmonic. It represents simple harmonic motion. It represents simple harmonic motion. Now, let us consider the second problem. So, trigonometrically, you know one relation, cos 2 theta, it can be written as cos square theta minus sin square theta, or 2 cos square theta minus 1, or 1 minus 2 sin square theta. So out of the three relations, which is useful to us? Here we are having sin square omega t, therefore this relation is useful for us. So here, let us bring this to left hand side and take this to right hand side. Sin square theta is equal to 1 by 2 1 minus cos 2 theta, or 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 cos 2 theta. So now here ours is f of t is equal to sin square omega t is equal to 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 cos 2 omega t. So this is the given expression. Now we have to check the SHM definitions. What are the SHM definitions for SHM? First definition is x is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. Second definition, y is equal to a sin omega t plus pi. Third definition also can be taken as third definition. See this, x is equal to a sin omega t plus b cos omega t. So in these three cases it can be simple harmonic. Now under which case it comes? Cos. So it is under x is equal to a cos omega t plus pi. Of course here pi is not there, means we can write as 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 cos 2 omega t plus 0. Like this you can write. So here pi becomes 0. And here this is amplitude a. A is equal to minus 1 by 2. And this is f of t. This is f of t or x of t, like that. Suppose the projection point is taken on. So here instead of f of t, you write x of t. Because the projection point is taken on x axis. The projection point is taken on x axis. So this also simple.